dear friends. Welcome to this edition of Segmental Anatomy of the Liver. This is part 5 of this video series on segmental anatomy. Now, we will take a brief recall of key slides from the previous videos before we move into this detailed discussion. Here is the photograph of the liver viewed from above. The right lobe and the left lobe are labeled. Even otherwise, the massive right lobe is too obvious to miss. On the posterior aspect, the IVC is clearly seen. The main portal fissure, which divides the liver into two physiological lobes, right and left, is shown. Similarly, the right portal fissure, which cuts through the right lobe. And now, keeping that IVC and all these other lobes in orientation, these are the positions of various segments of the liver that is recognizable in this view. We have had the detailed discussion in the previous video. Now, the objective of this video is we are going to dissect segment by segment and try to identify the portal vein branches, hepatic vein, and its tributaries to the extent possible. Now, you see, similarly, intersegmental demarcations as seen on the inferior surface. You can see the four lobes marked or labeled. The gallbladder is also labeled just adjacent to the quadrate lobe. And also, because of the discussion already given, it is a simple job to identify the segments by numbers. Now, once again, IVC just for locational confirmation. Now, this is where we have begun all the discussion. This is the porta hepatis, through which the portal vein enters the liver parenchyma. This is once again a quick retour of the four anatomical lobes. Now, that's the dissection of the portal vein. We have seen this in the previous video. It's a division into right and the left branches, very, very distinctly shown in this demonstration. The liver is viewed from below. One thing you must remember is, in the inferior view, the portal vein branching is very, very close to the surface. That means as you dissect through the porta hepatis, this side and that side, it's hardly 1 centimeter deep to the visceral surface. Now, that's the right branch and that's the left branch. Now, with that, we proceed to the current discussion of this video number 5. Now, you see, identifying the segments is an easy job. The numbers have already been told to you in the previous video, and these are the segments. But then concentrate on each of these segments. Particularly, I want you concentrate on those three yellow arrows. Those three yellow arrows demonstrate the boundaries using which I have created a wedge-shaped dissection. I will remove, say for example, in the segment 4, I will remove a triangular piece of liver tissue. But when I remove it, it looks like a wedge. That means I can just fit it back into the original location of the liver. Similarly, in the case of segment 8, I have made a somewhat quadrangular cut, and that will also be removed like a wedge. Not too deep, not too superficial, but adequate enough to just sit on the liver parenchyma. That's the way I have dissected. The next slide will show you how, when the lids are removed, you can actually see the interior of the liver segment. Same way, segment 5 also more or less a quadrangular piece. In fact, you can see the wedge has actually gone a little inside. This is just for comparison. Now, let's see the actual dissection. You see, once I remove it, it looks like pits. I repeat, it looks like pits. But then, these are very carefully dissected. The liver parenchyma has been teased out with the blunt end of the forceps. I very carefully proceeded, keeping in mind various textbook diagrams and other pictures, so that I don't lose even a single key structure. Fortunately, that carefulness and the academic preparation paid off, and finally I was able to get almost everything possible in terms of portal vein branches as far as this liver dissection is concerned. Now, there are certain other things I want to tell you as highlighted points. Now, I have given some reaper-like reinforcements, like, you know, in buildings and all, they'll put some steel rod or bar. These are all for, you know, for the demo purposes. I have digitally added it. It gives you the depth at which certain structures are visible, or how superficial certain other structures may be visible. See, for example, in 4, in this view, it's reasonably superficial, I would say, to the surface. Whereas in segment number 8, it's quite deep. You see, you remember the mass of tissue that comprises segment 8, segment 5, etc. Now, the yellow arrows in all the three segments are actually pointing to the portal vein branches. Note, it's very difficult to see it in this dissection or in this photograph, primarily because, as I told you in the immediately previous video, these are semi-transparent. It's very difficult. You have to keep an eye, and I recommend that it is dissected in bright light so that you don't miss the structure. Next slide. You see, we will go one by one. Now, by the technique I just showed you in the previous thing, here is the quadrangular window for segment 5. And I have, you have seen this segment 5 in the previous slide, but now what I have done is, because I did the dissection myself, I was able to clearly see the portal vein branch, so I have colored it for easy identification. Now that will be the segmental branch of the portal vein to the segment 5, and from the previous discussion we know that it is a branch from the right medial sectorial branch, inferior right medial sectorial branch. Likewise, you see, I have put those railings, etc., just as if it looks like some kind of an archaeological site, excavation. More or less the principle is the same. Only thing is, we have excavated the liver parenchyma, and here also you can see the branches of the portal vein. One is very clearly visible, but the other one is a little light. Anyway, I have put the label that is a segmental branch to the 8th segment, and from previous discussion we know that it is the superior right medial sectorial branch. I repeat, superior right medial sectorial branch. Likewise, let's proceed further. Now, this is, although it looks like a repeat of the previous slide, but this is only to introduce the two adjacent segments, namely segment 6 and segment 7. Segment 6 is below and segment 7 is above. Now, those two arrows here have a different purpose. If you look at the liver from the direction as pointed by the arrows, the same photograph will look like this. Now, you see, this is the view. You can see the 5 and 8 are on one side, and that is slightly out of the view. And you can see 6 and 7 that have come into view, of which 6 has been dissected with a triangular lid being removed. Here also you can see the branches of the portal vein. Remember, there is a right portal fissure, so we are on the right of the right portal fissure. Obviously, it is going to be supplied by the left sectorial branch of the portal vein. Just remember that. Now you see, now those are the branches of inferior right lateral sectorial branch. Inferior right lateral sectorial branch. Now, this is just for recall, that's the right portal fissure. Next stage of the dissection. So what I have done is, as I dissect the liver, segment by segment I have photographed it, and that's how I am able to build the discussion. Similarly, I put those steel bars or some kind of a attachments so as to give you an idea of the depth of this structure. Remember, we are trying to have a 2D photograph and trying to have a 3D interpretation. Therefore, this kind of digital add-ons or digital emphasis brings out a certain amount of realism. Remember, segment 7 is massive. It almost occupies the full upper half of this view of the liver. In contrast, see, the 6 is much less. Of course, it extends more posteriorly. Nevertheless, see, this quadrangular area for 7 is really, really huge. And you can actually see huge branches of these vessels. It may be portal vein, it may be hepatic vein, whichever it is, that we will come to in the next slide. Because they are very huge, unusually huge, remember, as we reach 7, the right hepatic artery is going to be there, and you will almost reach the right edge of the inferior vena cava. Therefore, such huge vessels will clearly indicate that we are getting more of hepatic vein and their tributaries rather than the portal vein branches. Now, if you look at the same photograph in the direction of this yellow arrow, the photograph, the new angle of view will be like this. By the by, and this is to say, when we look at the portal branch, it is the segmental branch to segment 7. It is the upper right lateral sectorial branch. Now back to the yellow arrow. We will try to take a photograph in the direction of this yellow arrow and review the same segment. You see, now further excavations have been done. There is already an yellow arrow blinking, meaning it is trying to catch our attention. That yellow arrow is something very special. It's not what you saw routinely in all the previous thing. It has to be contrasted with certain other structures. Before we identify what that yellow arrow is, let's recall a few points. This view is, because we moved from the front to the lateral and now more and more backwards, we have already reached the posterior inferior view. I repeat, we are in the posterior inferior view. IVC has to be recognized. Next to the IVC, the caudate lobe is very clearly seen. With this information in the background, let's try to identify some structures. Remember, we are in segment 7, where the right hepatic vein is going to be there. So it's invariably, you cannot miss it. And in contrast, we have to identify the portal vein branch, if any. Therefore, keeping that yellow mark, yellow arrow in pending status, let's try to identify. Now you see, this is not portal vein. What I am now showing is the tributaries of the right hepatic vein. Recall yesterday's, the previous video I showed you, in the immediately previous one, so that is video number 4. I told you, while dissecting, I have noticed that the portal vein branches are semi-transparent. Actually, you need really bright light to identify, whereas the hepatic vein tributaries are slightly dull, slightly bluish, therefore more darker in contrast with the other structure. Therefore, it is easy for the hepatic vein tributaries to be identified. And they are huge, you see, because they are very close to the inferior vena cava. The hepatic vein is almost, right hepatic vein is almost formed. Therefore, its first thing we have done is tributaries of the right hepatic vein. Then, it leaves no second thoughts for this yellow flashing structure. That has to be, you see, it's a little pale compared to this hepatic vein tributary. Therefore, that yellow arrow, what it is pointing, has to be a portal vein branch. Now, because it's not so clearly visible, I have used a digital painting. The next slide, I will show you that how it stands out in contrast. You see, slightly enlarged view. The hepatic vein tributaries are shown here in pinkish, darkish pink color, whereas blue is the portal vein branches. Remember, the size of the portal vein branches also has become smaller. Now you see, that is the tributaries of the hepatic vein, and now those are the branches of the portal vein. As we come to the end of the discussion, notice that it is here for further understanding how the blood from the portal vein through the portal triad reaches the parenchyma of the liver. That's where there is no further gross anatomy to talk of. This is the interface where the histology takes over. That's where we will discuss the as seen as various issues related to that, and how blood flows through the sinusoids and reaches the central vein. From the central vein, they all the blood flows into larger and larger vessels. Finally, they merge to form the three hepatic veins. Now, with that pending matter, that is the histology part kept aside, because there is a separate slide discussion on it, we will end this particular discussion on the segments of the liver. Maybe if possible, maybe one more video I will try to do, depending upon the quality of the specimen and the photographs. As I said, one video is coming immediately after this in the same context. There, what we will try to do is, we will have a summary of all that we have studied in the last 5 videos. Try to identify at random the various segments in different views of the liver. With that, we will be able to end this discussion. Thank you, my dear friends, for a very patient hearing. Also, please note, in part 6, we will be covering the 4 segments of the left physiological lobe. Here, I have covered only the 4 right physiological lobe segments. The 4 on the left side is pending. That will be covered in part 6. Thank you.